Hello, I'm doing a movie review, and the movie I want to review is the 1991 classic, The Silence of the Lambs. Now, as you can see, I have The Silence of the Lambs on VHS. I actually don't have this movie on DVD. Now, The Silence of the Lambs is based on the 1988 novel of the same name by Thomas Harris. Now, the book The Silence of the Lambs was actually a sequel to Thomas Harris's 1981 novel, Red Dragon, which itself was made into a movie in 1986 called Manhunter, meaning that this movie is technically a sequel to Manhunter. Now, I say this movie is a sequel to Manhunter. It is and it isn't. Like, it's a sequel to Manhunter in the sense that some of the same characters from Manhunter do show up in this movie, specifically the characters of Hannibal Lecter and Jack Crawford. However, the film was definitely not made as a sequel to Manhunter because in the movie they don't reference the events of Manhunter at all. You know, it was really made as a standalone movie that just happens to be based on a book which happened to be a sequel to the book Red Dragon, which happened to already get made into a movie, but really this film was not made as a sequel to Manhunter. It was really made as a standalone movie. Now, in Manhunter, Hannibal Lecter was played by Brian Cox. In this film, Hannibal Lecter is played by Anthony Hopkins. Also, in the previous film, Dennis Farina played Jack Crawford. In this film, Jack Crawford is played by Scott Glenn. Another character from Manhunter who shows up in this movie is the character of Dr. Chilton, who in Manhunter was played by Benjamin Hendrickson, but in this movie is played by Anthony Heald. Now, in the film, there's a character named Barney, who's actually played by Frankie Faison. I don't know if I'm saying his name right, but he was in Manhunter. However, he did not play the same character in Manhunter. So, the plot of the film is, it's about an FBI trainee named Clarice Starling, played by Jodie Foster in the movie. In the movie, she ends up getting sent in by Jack Crawford to interview Hannibal Lecter, who was a psychologist who actually murdered and cannibalized his patients, and he's now locked up in a psychiatric hospital. But while all this is going on, you find out that the FBI is also looking for a serial killer nicknamed Buffalo Bill, who has been killing women and actually taking parts of their skin. And it turns out that Hannibal Lecter has information which might help them catch this killer. So in the movie, a young woman ends up getting kidnapped by Buffalo Bill, and this young woman turns out to be the daughter of a senator. So now the media is paying close attention to this. And basically, in the movie, Clarice ends up being the one having to track down this killer and save this young woman. But throughout the movie, she goes to see Hannibal Lecter, who gives her information about Buffalo Bill. And throughout the movie, Hannibal and Clarice develop a very bizarre relationship with each other. Like, you can tell that Hannibal is kind of infatuated with Clarice. Now, in the movie, you find out that Buffalo Bill is actually a man named Jane Gum, who is a man who actually wants to be a woman, and it turns out that the reason he's removing parts of his victim's skin is because he's actually trying to create a suit made out of women to pursue this fantasy of him becoming a woman. Now, The Silence of the Lambs is, of course, an amazing movie. The film is extremely well made and very well acted, and I do personally like Manhunter a little bit better, but that's just me personally. Most people do say that this is a better film. I always personally preferred Manhunter myself, but most people say this film is better than Manhunter. Now, this film was definitely more successful than Manhunter. Manhunter, because when Manhunter came out, it unfortunately did not do very well, but when this movie came out, it did very well, and this film actually won a bunch of Academy Awards. This is actually one of the few films to actually win an Academy Award in all five categories, including Best Picture. Now, it's debatable on whether you would call this a horror film. A lot of people do consider it to be a horror film, and a lot of people consider it to be a crime drama film. I personally consider it to be both horror and crime drama, but if you do consider this to be a horror film, that means that this is also the first horror film to win Best Picture. However, The Exorcist, when it came out, was nominated for Best Picture. Now, Jodie Foster was amazing in her role as Clarice in this movie, and I loved the character of Clarice in this movie. Like, what I liked about Clarice is you can tell that she's definitely very inexperienced since she's only a trainee, but, but what I liked about her, though, is she's a very strong character, though. Like, a very strong-willed character. Like, in the scenes between her and Hannibal Lecter, you can tell that Hannibal is definitely trying to get under her skin. Like, when he's giving her information about Buffalo Bill, he's also asking her a lot of personal questions, like, about her childhood, and you can tell he's definitely trying to get under her skin, but you can tell that she's definitely not letting him do that. You know, so that's something I really liked about the character. She is a very strong character, in my opinion. And the character of Clarice has become a very iconic character, and I heard that she's actually going to, at some point, be incorporated in the television series Hannibal, and apparently Lifetime is actually making a series about her, which that should be interesting, I guess. Now, Anthony Hopkins is also amazing in his role as Hannibal Lecter in this movie. Now, even though he wasn't the first person to play this character, he's definitely the most iconic Hannibal Lecter. Like, when most people think about Hannibal Lecter, they think of Anthony Hopkins, like, and he also won an Academy Award for his role in this movie, and he does do an amazing job in this movie. Now, even though I do like Manhunter better, I do have to say, though, that if I were to compare Brian Cox Hannibal Lecter with Anthony Hopkins' portrayal of Hannibal, I honestly can't compare them because they are two very different interpretations of the character, but in this movie, they definitely make Hannibal more of a center character because in the first movie, Manhunter, Hannibal was really more of a side character, but in this movie, he's definitely one of the main characters. Now, in the movie, Ted Levine plays the villain, Jane Gum, aka Buffalo Bill, and he's freaking creepy as shit in this movie. Like, Buffalo Bill is a really disturbing character, and, you know, there's a really disturbing but also very iconic scene in the movie where Buffalo Bill is wearing this suit that he made out of his victims, and he's dancing in front of a camera to the song Goodbye Horses, which in the movie is a very disturbing scene. However, that scene has been parodied many times after this movie. Kevin Smith fans will probably remember a parody of that scene in Clerks 2. Now, Buffalo Bill is actually based on a couple of real-life serial killers, specifically Ted Bundy and Ed Gein. Now, I understand Ed Gein wasn't technically a serial killer because I believe he only killed, like, two people, and in order to be a serial killer, you have to kill, I believe, more than that. I know it's freaking creepy as hell that I actually know this information, but I know Ed Gein wasn't technically a serial killer, but Buffalo Bill is loosely based on Ed Gein. Now, one thing that's interesting is filmmaker Roger Corman actually has a small role in this movie, and I shit you not, George A. Romero actually has a very brief cameo appearance in this movie as well. Now, I have read the book that this movie is based on, and I have to say that this movie is actually really true to the book. However, in the book, since the book was a sequel to Red Dragon, they do mention the character of Will Graham quite a bit in the book. But however, since this movie was not intended as a sequel to Manhunter, they remove all references to Will Graham in the film. Also, in the book, there was a subplot about how Jack Crawford's wife was dying from, I believe, cancer, and it was a really good subplot in the book because it adds a lot of depth to the character of Jack Crawford, but it probably is a good thing that they cut that out of the movie, because even though it does add a lot of depth to the character of Jack Crawford, it honestly probably would have slowed the movie down. But besides removing all the references to Will Graham and that subplot about Jack Crawford's wife, I would say that the film is pretty true to the book. But yeah, that's my review on The Silence of the Lambs, and bye.